ora koutou, talofa lava, bula vanaka, ma loelele, ki ora na whakalofa lahi atu, namaste, ni hao, and g'day. It is my honour to perform a 9-minute poem for you tonight, so sit back and relax and enjoy. And there are lots of little sparks going off in my head as I was listening to the conversation, so I do hope you enjoy the poem and the gorgeous accompaniment by Karam. New Zealand, the lucky country, Aotearoa, land of divine poetry, where Papa Tua Nuku and Rangi, lovers of land, sky and sea, progenitors of Māori. Yes, New Zealand's a lucky country. Lucky the brothers were restless sons. Lucky they warred when dark had won. Lucky they longed for the light of the sun and the warmth of the open air. Lucky Tane was the heart-led son, seeking bloodless revolution. Lucky he had the strength to stand and pry his parents apart. Lucky the lovers loved so much, missing the caress of each other's touch. For Rangi cries tears from the sky so freely, and Papa's fecund soil so healing, giving us Tane Mahuta's forests of jade green, rivers, lakes, underground springs, a green belt round this nation's hips, kissed all over by Moana's blue lips. From Te Waipounamu to Te Ika a Maui, green stone to fishtail, lucky, lucky country. See the Pahutakawa blush deeply, along cliff edges rising steeply, where the dead depart for Hawaiki. From Cape Reanga to Raki Ure's sea, yes, New Zealand's a lucky country. If you're not tangata whenua, you're tangata te riti, whether British, South African or Somali, Chinese, Indian or Aussie, we've got the diversity, no ethnic cleansing policy. Well, except for around 1833, that infected blanket strategy, Britain's manifest destiny, taking land by any means necessary. Platform for Māori fighting land wars, foreshores, bastion, pointing the way to O blessed Te Riti o Waitangi, setting a fire in your belly against paternalistic tyranny. Just do it, said Sir T. Penny, and way before Nike. Yes, New Zealand's a lucky country, this land home to migrant Tau Iwi, from 1858 Wellington Gujarati to Al Wentz flying fox in a freedom tree, John Pule's tapa tall canvas 10 metres by 3, where 250,000 at Western Springs drink deep from the well, hear them sing. Kiribati, Fijians, Tuvaluan, Samoans, PNGs, Solomon Islanders, Ni Vanuatu, New Zealand borns. And the fusion from Niue to Scottish Highlanders makes Fijongans, Raramoans, and Pakeha Islanders. We had our Muldoon, but he was no Mugabe. We're fourth in the world with the least political conspiracy. We wear our slogan t-shirts freely. In Queen Street, I see Politicians are the same all over. They promise a bridge where there is no river. And this one from Taupo down by the lake. In New Zealand, anyone can be Prime Minister. It's a risk you take. New Zealand's a lucky country where our birthright civic duty lets you vote or not. It's free. There's no one purple finger vote. No machete held at your family's throat. No AK-47 to persuade you at the polls. No standing in the dust, waving the same flag as the presidential rolls. New Zealand's a lucky country where inconvenient geography, no landlocked topography, we're far but close enough to see that our dairy economy makes the milk in this land of honey. Kiwi Shakespeare sharing farming families, gumboot brigading, black singlet parading, number 8 wire mentality, an enterprise and industry. It's Fred Dagg haggling in the city. And we've got water like no other, wind turbines and solar power, and Antarctica, terra australis incognito, our polar explorers, our global heroes. It's a land of opportunity, hard work meeting synchronicity, where we can still think differently, because we're Te Moana Nuia Kiwis, Kiwis. Tōtara Waka Park next to chromed Humvee, next to Vespa, next to Uncle Souped Up Taxi, where beaching beauty is for free. Kiwi Christmases, tent cities, jandals flip-flopping, Rachel Hunter tip-topping, bare feet lapping the sea under our holy ozone CV. Brotown cartooning, our TV, eagle versus shark mentality, Jim Baxter's Jerusaleming it in Ponsonby, drinking Sam Hunt's DB bitter poetry and Mansfield's Devonshire scones over a cup of tea, round Wellington's hive of blue-suited bees, or like our beloved Sir Paul Reeves, corduroy jacket dignitaries. Yes, New Zealand's a lucky country. It's a plucky country where you can buy MDs and KFC not next to pork bones, puha and balusami, taro kumara and sapa sui, swirling Indian curries, Korean walking, no MSG, in Otara's free market of inclusivity. And don't we do so good globally? Our first Olympic gold, South Island boys Rowan, Picton's Joe Sullivan, Invercargill's Nat Cohen. Our last Olympic gold, our shot put in Kiwi Tongan, Valerie Adams wins the day after writing all that wrongin'. New Zealand's a lucky country when our nation's greatest anomaly is the freedom to be or not to be, to be nouveau culture or customary, to walk with burqa or face and hair free, to wear ta'ovala or legs bare for all to see. New Zealand's a lucky country, but like Sir Tipene and Sir Paul Reeves, we've got to horizon seek, otherwise it's good night, Kiwi. And everything we think is free lies hostage to a world economy. We need intergenerationality, eco-sustainability for our fossil fuels and energy in this land of space, water and sea. We need a bit of Sir Ed Hillary, who had the same fears as you and me, but not the bastard off anyway. Yes, New Zealand, a lucky, 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 lucky country.
Mountains, the place in our history.